Oh, what a day this has turned out to be. Keith's outside thinking we will get dinner at some point today. Anyway, tropical plants Finland. This is regarding the Psychopsis, mariposa. And he says he thought that that little thing that I thought was a root, he thought it was a bush snail. And he's correct. So, no more ado. I thought, oh goodness gracious, here we go. So, these don't like to be repotted. And, but I haven't got a choice now. We've got a new growth coming. And we've got bush snails. Because if there's one, there'll be more. So what I've done in preparation, hydrogen peroxide. Coconut husk soaking. And this is coming out with a TDS of at 118. And a pH of 6.37. And it's just started to hydrate. It's actually in rainwater. So let's get it out of the pot. And it'll just have to sink or swim, because at the end of the day, I've got to do something about these bush snails. For me, I mean, I didn't disturb it too much, but I'm going to disturb it now, and I'm going to give it a treatment, because you've got no alternative when you see bush nails. Because, like I say, if you see one, you'll see more than one, and. So, and let's just have a look here. Let's see what we're dealing with. I mean, there are a lot of people who, and to be frank, you know, I used to always unpot my new orchids. This is potted in cocoa fibre. And some of it's breaking down a bit. And those roots, I've been in here a while. You see, it's not until you open it up. That all is revealed. We've got a little bit of mould. There, can you see? A little bit of mould on that root as well. Oh dear. I said to Keith, oh, I said, I'll have to do a repot now. I said, do you mind? He said, well, would it matter if I did? I said, well, no, not really, but, you know, you have to be polite, don't you? Just, anyway. Let's see what we're dealing with. There is another little growth coming at the base of that one. There. But we can't be concerned with that one at the moment, because we've got to deal with... Oh, look at that. That's a live root. We've got to deal with this media here. And of course, I was advised to check it. So I'm looking for bush snails. Those are those tiny, tiny little snails. And they can play havoc. So, the other half of the watering of my mounts didn't get done. But what can you do? Crisis or something happens, you've just got to deal with it. And with the good humidity I've got, I think it was before I opened the doors and started messing, I think it was 72, with a little bit of live moss there. Let's see if we can I might have to discard that anyway, because that might be holding bush snails. And anyhow, this is going to appreciate, maybe not at first, it might sulk, but it's the best time if I've got a new growth coming through there and something at the side of it. Look at this here. Can you see how it was originally growing? That's the old, can you see? That's the sphagnum moss. Plug. So it's a darn good job that I've that this has been spotted for me, because at the end of the day I need to give this Psychopsis a good growing season. And every chance not to be eaten by bush snails. Let's see if I can get this underneath here. I mean, really, all this should actually come free with putting it in water. So, what a mess. Now, where's my new growth? Right. Here we go. And then, so what I've done wrong, of course, is I've wet it. Now, you're not supposed to do that. You're supposed to apply your hydrogen peroxide first, and then after you can rinse it. Because if I apply it on this one now, there's no point, because at the end of the day, the hydrogen peroxide won't work. So I might have to stall the video. And come back. I mean, there might be some roots here, like that one. You see that one? That's not much good at all. But there are actually some nice roots. I just need to free it of this moss plug. See where the roots have gone round and round and round and round. Maybe that one's a damaged one. Let me see if I can rinse it a bit more, just to loosen a little bit more of this sphagnum moss. And then see, that's where it started originally. Can you see the little back bulb there? And then the second one, and then it's grown on since then. heaven and grey comes to Squippy Darley. They always say, well, you mustn't repot that. Oh, it hates its roots to be disturbed. I tell you, sometimes you do things and you just think, well, you're going to have to sink or swim, because you've got to come out of this media. Right, now what have we got? Looking at that now, I don't know whether you'll see that. Can you see inside that, there? That suitable, that's had the outer part nibbed away. And if you look there, behind the spike, that's also had it nibbed away. So it's definitely had a chomper in here. I think he's had the whole darn family of chompers. So, it's definitely got to be sprayed. Sure, it's going to feel better for being in a nice new moisture retaining fresh media, because it is producing new roots. Can you see that new root there? And this is the perfect time for that new root there to get down into this media and be settled. Sorry, I mean, I'm lifting this up and forgetting that I'm supposed to be sharing this with you. See, there's that other tiny, not that bit, there's that growth there, and there's, was that sheath there, and just behind that sheath, that's where the little bush snail was. So, let's have a look what we're dealing with now. How can I bring you down any closer? There we go. Okay. See the pieces of bark? I'm just going to take these pieces of bark off, because it's going to go in coconut husk. What I needed to do and I didn't do, which I'm going to have to do now, is just wash this pot. In this water. And then I'm going to dry it and spray hydrogen peroxide in this pot. Normally I have all my cloths up here. I probably have got them somewhere, but I can't just find them at the moment. I wonder where they are. I'm desperately looking around here. Right, I'm back again, so let's just spray in here. I don't like hydrogen peroxide. Well, for a start, it really hurts my hand. But I will leave that there now to fizz away. And got the cloths, varying colours. Let's have a look what we can do here, and hopefully it'll dry out a little bit while I'm trying to untangle these roots. There we go. See all these lighter coloured ones? They're fine. There's nothing wrong with these. And it's the very dark ones. That might not be any use. But let's have a look. See, you've got one there, can you see? Where it's just that little area there. So you've got a root there. Maybe that's just bruised. See, these roots have gone round and round and round and have attached to one another. So see that one? I broke the velamen on that. So let's just take it back. It's damaged there. Well, it's damaged further back. You see that one? It's damaged further back. So I'm going to take that one off. It's just that end coming off. This has a branching root system, so that's quite lucky. I've got one here. That's died back somewhat. This one looks as though it's died back a little bit. So let's see what we're dealing with here. See, to all intents and purposes, you'd think that one had gone, but it hasn't. Still a little bit of moss under there. Right. Okay, so we're up close now. Some of these roots in here. They're dead. I should have my gloves on, really. Because if there's anything else came out besides bushnells, I'd be absolutely frightened to death. Let's just have a look. Which scissors have I got? Those are no good. I need to use these. course you can see that new root there. Believe it or not, let's just take this little bit of I think that here, can you see where my finger is? Or there anyway, it's flowered from that area. So funny how they grow. So I'm gonna go in here. Let me come back to you. So what I've done, I've taken off these two little tiny back bulbs there and there. I didn't think they were serving any purpose, tucked right in there, which then will enable me to really inside here and get the rest of this moss out. From right inside here. And then once I've done that and I've been able to spray it, then I should be happy to repot it. Oh dear. Right, so let's give this a spray and then we'll pot it up. That one wants cutting. Hydrogen peroxide, here we go. Excuse me. That's because I'm spraying the hydrogen peroxide. There's actually not a lot of sizzle. So, those areas that I thought, you see, were damaged in the pseudo bulbs here, I'm going to spray actually inside them. And hopefully there'll be nothing coming out. So do I think this orchid will sulk? Probably. eventually it'll settle down into its new coconut husk, and it should be fine. I mean, you can absolutely go paranoid thinking, well, have I cleaned it enough? Have I got everything out? I don't think I've done too bad. And those are the roots we're left with. I'm going to just bring you up a bit now. Okay. And let's have a look. Use the coffee. There we go. Okay, let's see if see, that's the coconut husk. You see when you squeeze it, how much water it holds. So let's see if I can manoeuvre this in. Right, so that's the new growth there. So let's see if I can just manoeuvre it in older. Okay, so there we go, there's that new growth there. And I've got these pseudo bulbs. I'm just going to try and hold this one here. Some of this coconut husk